Chris Colbert, 13-0. Jezreel Corrales, 23-3. Corrales, just enough of a veteran to make things difficult on Colbert.
Yeah, this was a pretty frustrating fight, you know, tonight, I think, all the way around. And that kind of proves it right there, right? That act right there showed how frustrating this was.
Corrales had his moments, again, able to land some shots, possibly win some rounds. You see the straight shots right there, landed by Corrales. Colbert, though, maintained his poise and was able to land his shots and do the damage.
Yeah, it was more Colbert than it was Corrales tonight, but Corrales did have his moments, and it was a very difficult guy.
And here you see them trading punches, trading shots. And here we're going to see a good combination by Colbert knock him down, Corrales.
Yeah, that was a nice little hook. He chopped away. He finally got to him on the inside. And there, again, close. He started landing some good shots here. And this was the combination where
there was no knockdown.
Right, right. But again, he was getting hit with good punches. But I agree with Larry. We won't call that a knockdown. If I was in the corner, I would have been calling for the referee to call that a knockdown, though.
Sportsmanship there at the end. And
ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of action, we have a unanimous decision here. The score totals. Judge at ringside, David Braslow, scores the mount 116 to 111. Judges Dewey LaRosa and Steve Weisfeld both see it 117 to 110. All three in favor of the winner by unanimous decision. And now, the interim WBA Super Featherweight World Champion, Chris Primetime Colbert.
Chris Colbert had to work for it here against the veteran Jezreel Corrales, but he gets the win and he gets a nominal belt again. Everything helps marketing-wise if you grab an interim belt here or there. He's already calling out the best fighters in the world, including Leo Santa Cruz.
Chris, your little boy Prince here, yes, in the ring. Yes. You get your first piece of hardware at 23 years old. I know how hard you work for this, but you had to work extra hard for it here tonight. I spoke to your coach Sosa during this fight. He said people don't realize how frustrating and how hard this fight really is. What was it that was so difficult for you?
First of all, I'd like to thank God. I'd like to thank Al Heyman, my team, Sosa Crew, Team Primetime. Shout out to Brooklyn that came through. Shout out to Philly that supported me. But back to your question, Corrales is a great fighter. People don't realize that because he had a bad decision against Ladarius Miller, but he's a great fighter. He's very awkward, he's slick, he's fast. So it was kind of hard to like keep up, catch him, because he was running, but he came to fight, and I tip my hat off to him.
Well, he was the former champion. You took that belt from him here, not from him tonight, but you took that vacant interim belt home, yes, tonight. In terms of the action, it was the 10th round when things did change. The momentum changed when you were able to take that clinch away from him and get that knockdown. How much confidence did that give you going forward?
I had confidence coming into the fight. I knew I was going to dominate the fight. I told y'all this before the fight happened. But he was running. I was just trying to catch him. So I decided, I told my corner, my dad, I wanted to have a dog fight. Let's fight. We got 12 rounds. I'm in shape. Y'all see how to sit down now, one round.
I saw that.
I'm in shape, and I came to fight. And I wasn't leaving without this title.
You have called out big names coming into this fight. You said, Leo Santa Cruz, I want you next. Well, he's talked about fighting Gervonta, but should that fight not fall through, is that what you would like to see next?
I mean, if that fight don't fall through, I got the best advisor slash manager in the game, Al Heyman. He know what to do. He know I'm not ducking nobody and I ain't dodging nobody. I'm here to fight and I'm here to stay.
You are definitely impressive as always. Congratulations on that new piece of hardware.
Sunday on Fox, Aaron Rodgers looks to move one step closer to a second ring.
Touchdown!
But Jimmy Garoppolo and the 49ers stand in his way. The NFC Championship game presented by Intuit TurboTax. Sunday on Fox and the Fox Sports app.
Thank you for watching. Well, if you enjoyed that clip, make sure you click somewhere around here and subscribe. From fight highlights to exclusive interviews, we have got everything you need as a boxing fan right here on PBC on Fox.